going to tell you about a project that we recently finished. It's called Parents Integration Through Partnership Project, PIP for short, that was funded using European Integration Funding and the GLA's English the Key to Integration. And the main overall goal of the programme was to improve the quality of teaching provision for non-EU EAL pupils in primary and secondary schools and the English skills of non-EU EAL mothers, and to encourage the mothers' involvement in the school community. And the PIP project actually focused on the mums. We were interested to see how engaging the mums could make a difference both for the mums and their confidence in supporting their children's learning both at home and at school. And hopefully we wanted the mums to get more involved in school settings as well. So these were our overall aims, and I'm sure we all recognise how marginalised and isolated some families can be where they don't have English as the first language. So we really wanted as much as possible to support the mums and carers to, as I said, develop their skills, participate more in the schools, and really increase their skills, confidence, understanding about supporting their children's learning, particularly if the mums felt very self-conscious about their own English. They often say, well, I can't read very well, my English is terrible, what can I do? So we used a range of strategies to support the mums in recognising the value of bilingualism and different ways they can support children's learning at home. And also we wanted to build bridges from the classroom with the mums so that they could actually have opportunities to meet and interact with school staff, the reception staff, and also other local service providers, because we felt all of that would impact on the well-being of the family and hopefully the mums and the children's learning. So we had a holistic project which included the ESOL classes for the mums, lots of trips, events, workshops. We also had invited some guest speakers, and we did some CPD training with school staff, TAs and reception staff and so on. But for the actual ESOL classes, we consulted with the parents and the partners about what they thought would be really good. So all of the language learning was topic-based and contextualised. And for each topic that was covered, we tried to think of opportunities, someone who we could invite into the class to talk to the mums or do activities with the mums, as well as a trip or visit or tour to a particular part of a school that the mums could go on. So that's an example of some of the topics we covered. And as I said, the trips, workshops, events were really important. Lots of families had never been to the seaside at all. Some didn't know where their local swings or park were. And you know, things like free messy play sessions for preschool children and so on. So we really tried to get the mums out a lot with their families, and also volunteers. As part of building bridges, we trained and supported other parents to become volunteers to support the parents on our programme, and that really made a huge impact as well. And some of our higher level mums, PIP mums, also became volunteers, and I'm sure you can imagine that having support from someone who's got a sort of shared life experience can be particularly effective. Volunteers also set up conversation clubs, so in addition to the classes that met twice a week, we'd have conversation clubs, and for some it's just a really nice opportunity to have a cup of tea and cake and a chat and sort of make friends, because as I say, you know, I'm sure we all know a lot of these families are very isolated. But also it was opportunities to practice for the ESOL exams that the mums took, and also again to invite in visiting professionals and specialists. It could be the vitamin D lady or someone talking about family learning, bilingualism and so on. And also, as research shows, when language learning has a real meaning for people, their progress, their confidence just comes along in leaps and bounds. So we sort of very much use participatory methods. So we don't always go in with a preset plan about what's going to be covered. We try and get that from the learners themselves. And this group of mums in particular to Children's Centre were really concerned about the proposed closure of their Children's Centre, and that became the main context for their language learning. And some of the mums went from being really shy, quiet, reserved class members to becoming really vocal members of their community. They started tweeting, they went on lobbies and demonstrations, they issued press releases. Some, as a result, were then invited to address the Haringey Cabinet meeting when they were discussing cuts. And some were even interviewed on breakfast television, which was really exciting. And so they also had the chance to take part in a participatory video project. So they also learnt how to make a film, and they made their own film about the Children's Centre and how important it is to them and their families. And they organised screenings with discussion. That's a local councillor giving feedback from her group discussion following the film. I'm afraid there isn't time to show it to you today, but if you want to look on the Learning Unlimited website, you can see the film and other participatory videos that our learners have made. So we're really proud of what we achieved on the project. We have really dedicated partners, staff and volunteers. And we did our own impact assessment. There was also an external research company looking at the impact of the project. But the data clearly shows that being involved in the project made a big difference. Sorry, I'm just going to read this list here. To the mums, they became much more skilled and confident in English. We had 99% pass rate on the speaking and listening exams. And that's for some mums who actually had interrupted primary education and their formal education stopped at primary. So that was a huge achievement for them in particular. There was increased interaction with teachers, with office staff and reception staff. The mums made friends, and as a result their families interacted more with other families, and the children had the opportunity to have play dates and go to the park after school rather than going straight home. The mums did more reading at home with their children, even mums who had very low literacy levels themselves. They, you know, we used different approaches and strategies with them. And the mums generally felt a lot more confident about supporting their children's learning. What we did, we put into this toolkit, so there's lots of examples of different the topics, the activities, the visits, and there are, it's free to download on our website, and there are some copies there. And particularly given the cuts to ESOL in the UK that we're facing now, classes like these for parents in primary schools and children's centres will be become even more important.
Brilliant.
Thank you.